How the telephone was invented, the inventors, and the timelines. The telephone is an old device and one of the most valuable patents from the olden days. Before technology got to its peak in the 21st century, the telephone was one of the earliest technologies used as a source of communication. The telephone went through a series of modifications, taking different forms of structures, which is why the invention of the telephone cannot just be credited to only one person. It is the collective work of various developers. The telephone's little beginning. In the beginning, mechanical devices that could be used to transmit words and music over a long distance were in use. The first devices involved the transmission of sound through physical media, such as pipes. One such example was the acoustic tin can telephone, also known as the lover's phone. It worked by connecting two diaphragms with a wire that would relay sound by sending mechanical vibrations from one end of the wire to the other without making use of electric currents. It was made for children to play with by connecting two paper cups, plastic bottles, and metal cans. Between 1664 and 1685, British physicist Robert Hooke continued to conduct experiments based on the tin can telephone. In 1667, he was credited for the development of the acoustic string phone. In the 1700s, scientists in Europe studied the use of telegraphs that employed electrostatic attraction, but it was abandoned as being impractical. However, in 1774, George Louis de Sage developed an electric telegraph with a separate wire representing the 26 letters of the alphabet, but with a range only between two rooms in his home. Up until the 1800s, the acoustic telephones were still in use commercially, but as the telephone patent expired and many telephone manufacturers began to compete, the acoustic telephone manufacturers closed down. In 1804, inventor and scientist Francisco Salva researched the telegraphs, made improvements, and created the electrochemical telegraph based on electrical signals. In 1833, Carl Friedrich Gauss and Wilhelm Edward Weber built an electromagnetic device designed for the transmission of telegraphic signals. This production was done at the University of Göttingen in Lower Saxony and became known as the electromagnetic telegraph. In 1844, Innocenzo Manzetti, among others, first considered the idea of the telephone as we know it today. In 1854, there was a French engineer, Charles Bussel, who proposed the first design of a make-and-break telephone. He explained that for a person to speak through a movable disc with a vibration of the voice, the disc will alternately make and break the current from a battery, and another disc will be used as a separation distance that will simultaneously execute the same vibration. Bussel said that in the distant future, speech will be transmitted through electricity. However, Bussel was unable to build the telephone. The Rees telephone was invented in 1857 by John Philip Rees. The transmitter was allegedly difficult to operate because the relative position of the needle and contact were critical to the device's operation. However, it was considered a telephone since it could transmit voice sound electrically over a distance, but it was hardly used commercially as a practical telephone. In 1854, Antonio Meucci invented an early voice communicating device. He called it a telethon. Meucci claimed to have invented a paired electromagnetic transmitter and receiver where the motion of the diaphragm modulated a signal in a coil and electronic magnet. He was credited with an invention of inductive loading of telephone wires to increase distant signals in the 1880s, as well as the invention of an anti-sidetone circuit that maintained two separate telephone cuts and used twice as many transmission wires. Mucci also claimed that his first attempt to create a telephone occurred in Italy. Unfortunately, Mucci failed to develop his invention commercially in America because of serious burns from an accident, lack of English, and poor business ability. Alexander Bell's contributions. Alexander Graham Bell brought up an improved idea because he had a good understanding of the nature of sound and music. This allowed him to perceive the possibility of transmitting more than one message along the same wire at a time, a solution which he called the harmonic telegraph. Towards the end of 1874, Bell's experiment had progressed so far that he was confident enough to announce the possibility of running multiple telegraphs. Bell's idea was backed by his future father-in-law, attorney Gardiner Green Herbert, who gave him all the necessary financing required to work on his idea of developing the multiple telegraphs. Herbert actually saw Bell's idea as an opportunity to break the monopoly ascertained by the Western Union Telegraph. Bell had an assistant, Thomas Watson, a very brilliant young electrician. They both had the idea to create a device that could transmit the human voice electrically, but Bell failed to tell Herbert about this. They continued to work on the harmonic telegraph with the insistence and support of the other financial backers, including Herbert. On June 1875, they built a device capable of turning those tones into varying electric current and a receiver that would reproduce the variation and turn them back into audible format. On May 10, 1876, Bell finally invented the first practical telephone and was the founder of the American Telephone and Telegraph Company in 1885. His thorough knowledge of sound and acoustic had a major impact in the development of his telephone, which gave him the edge over others working on a similar project at the time, and he received an award for the first US patent for the invention of the telephone that same year. Right before the invention of the telephone, the telegraph had been a successful communication system for at least 30 years before Bell brought about his inventive idea. The telegraph and the telephone were similar, as both could transmit sound through electrical cables. But Bell's attempt to improve the telegraph led to his success with the telephone. In 1836, Samuel Morse invented the Morse code. What made the telephone more preferable than the telegraph at the time of its creation was the fact that the telegraph used the Morse code. That is, a person could only send and receive messages one at a time. This was a major problem with the use of the telegraph. In January 1878, the very first United States telephone exchange was opened for commercial use in New Haven, Connecticut. In the late 1800s, the candlestick telephone, a new and smaller version of the telephone, was launched. The transmitter would be placed on a stand, which was shaped like a candlestick, and when the phone was not in use, the receiver would hang on a hook with a switch known as a switch hook located in it. By 1900, there were nearly 600,000 phones in Bell's telephone system. The number rose to 2.2 million by 1905 and 5.8 million by 1910. At this time, the US had become the world's leader in terms of telephone use. Towards the mid-1900s, the bell and induction coil was enclosed at the bottom of the telephone, which in turn resulted in the need for a separate ringer box. And in years to come, the network that the telephone used continued to grow bigger and more efficient. The rotary dial was introduced during the time but was replaced by the touch tone signaling in the 1960s. The mobile phones. Along the same timelines, in 1947, the hexagonal cell transmissions for mobile phones was proposed by two engineers that worked for Bell Labs, Douglas H. Ring and W. Ray Young. Unfortunately, the technology to support the mobile phones remained underdeveloped until 1960, when two other scientists worked for the same company, Richard H. Frenkel and Joel S. Engel built the electronics that would support it. Today, the numbers of mobile phone users is about 5 billion. The telephone has been a great instrument to support modernization by supporting the development of suburbs and communication between homes and businesses. Thank you for watching our videos. We'd like to give you another interesting video for you to enjoy next. But before then, our team will be very happy if you can like this video and share it with your friends on social media. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss other interesting videos like this. Look at your screen now to see two other videos we handpicked for you to enjoy next. We love you.